The kiwi is in the other room. If you don't want to use this homemade mask, then get yourself a whole lot of kiwi and oranges. But one way you can get yourself a homemade mask is apply a paper clip to the coffee filter. You can get these any type of string or... Turns out every YouTuber in the world, from Timbuktu to Tokyo to LA to Zimbabwe, has figured out in the last 2 days how to turn a coffee filter into a mask. Let's take a look. So a friend of mine called me up this morning and says, I got a brilliant idea. I said, yeah, you got new ideas coming in every day. He says, yes, we're going to make a fortune. All we have to do is turn these coffee filters into protective masks. Yes, we're going to be rich tomorrow. And I said, okay, sounds like a great idea to me. But unfortunately, after a little research, I find out that every YouTuber, pretty much a million YouTubers, all at the same time, has figured out how to do your do-it-yourself protective mask with a coffee filter. Well, it's kind of logical, because when you look at a coffee filter, they're the exact same size as your surgical mask. Now, the whole premise is how to attach the coffee filter to your face. Most people use rubber bands or elastic. Now, this is a good idea. You use a hole puncher. You can use a hole puncher to punch a hole through the mask, and then you can put rubber bands in there. A lot of people use a rubber band chain. Most of the YouTubers have figured out somehow to attach it to the ear. And a lot of people use elastic. A lot of people are using a stapler, and they're stapling an elastic string. You just staple it to the coffee filter. It really is an ingenious idea. Of course, you can use string and just tie it to the back of your head. I'm really impressed with all the brilliant ideas the Americans are coming up with when it really gets down to the nitty-gritty. And, you know, all the masks are gone. People are hoarding the mask. But each idea seems to revolve around tape, staples. But one of the most ingenious ideas I found out was hot glue. If you have a hot glue gun, you can actually put the hot glue on the coffee filter and attach your string or your elastic string using hot glue. So there's probably, I don't know, maybe 100 different ways you can attach your rubber band or your elastic to the coffee filter. And for now, I think you can still get coffee filters out there at the supermarkets. Just a little update. The only stores that are allowed open, I think, are gas stations and supermarkets. Yes, during this collapse of the economy, I think they'd rather you stay at home and watch the Kardashians as they try to figure out how they're going to rearrange the economy. It's going to be interesting how we're going to have an economy in 3 months now that the banks are broke. And well, now the banks are not really broke, because the government can push a $1 trillion button, and I think Donald Trump's going to give the banks $1 trillion tomorrow and yesterday and the next day. What's $1 trillion here and there? Anyhow, a million YouTubers have figured out how to make a mask, a protective mask out of coffee filters. Here's one of my, this is my favorite. The guy uses a hot glue gun. And the reason why I like this is because I think the elastic is going to stay on there when the hot glue dries. I think this might be a better deal, might be a better idea than actual staples, where the staples and the tape might come loose. So anyhow, there you have it. I hope you've enjoyed all these great ideas on how to make a mask. But I got another idea. Well, China's figured out that if you eat a lot of oranges and kiwi and you pump yourself full of vitamin C, guess what? That might be better than a mask. Hey, take it for what it's worth. Or get yourself a rubber band and a coffee filter. Good luck.